Welcome to Network Edge, the platform that enables you to modernize your network virtually. In this video, we will dive into the product, our supported vendor services, as well as step-by-step guide on creating a virtual device with a virtual connection. One of the key things that our customers are continuing to deal with as they migrate towards digitalization is a need to support real-time interactions, globalization, cybersecurity and data compliance, as well as the supporting global business processes through connecting customers, partners, and employees. Network Edge addresses these points. Network Edge is a virtual networking service model that complements Equinix's co-location portfolio, allowing customers to extend into more locations by establishing a virtual point of presence within Equinix data centers. Using Network Edges, customers can select, configure, and connect virtual network services in real time across a platform, including routers, firewalls, and SD-WAN devices from the world's leading vendors. To get started with Network Edge, you'll need to create an Equinix Fabric account. From here, you'll be able to configure, purchase, and manage your virtual connections, virtual network devices, ports, view your inventory, customize your company profile, as well as manage accounts through various administrative functions. To get started with creating a virtual device, hover over the Network Edge tab and select the Create Virtual Device button. Select a vendor package for the device you'd like to deploy. From here, select your preferred deployment module. You can deploy a single virtual device, a redundant device, or a cluster device. Single slash standalone device in Equinix Network Edge is a basic deployment option for a single virtual network function instance. A single virtual device can also be added to an existing instance to create redundancy. Redundant devices are separate Network Edge instances for individual failover, while clustered devices act as a single logical unit with active slash standby for high availability. Once you have decided on the type of device you are looking to create, click Begin and Next, select the location where you'd like to deploy the virtual device, as well as your preferred billing account. Once you have selected that, select a licensing option. You can either bring your own license or purchase a licensing subscription through Equinix, which comes with end-to-end support. Note that not all vendors support the licensing subscription. Next, select the appropriate device resources, software package, version, license, term length, and fill in the remaining device details such as your device name, number of interfaces, users who you would like to receive device notification, and any other optional details such as purchase order number and order reference slash identifier. From here, click Next and fill out the additional services section by adding additional bandwidth as needed and confirming your term length selection. Note that setting up SSH with RSA public keys is optional. Once you're done, click Next to review your order details. On this page, you'll be able to review all of your configuration details, shared support structure, and accept the Equinix terms and conditions. Note that shared support structure checkbox must be selected and order terms must be accepted in order for the device to be created and provisioned. After submitting an order, you receive an email with the order details and another once device provisioning is completed. Once provisioned, you can add and edit additional services including VPN, SSH users, additional bandwidth, and more from the virtual device section in the inventory tab. Once your device is provisioned, you can begin to create virtual connections to your newly provisioned virtual device. To do so, click Create Connection and choose the type of connection you're looking to establish. For this demo, I will establish a private virtual connection to Google Cloud. Select Google Cloud Connection and click Create Connection after reviewing the steps. Once you're ready to proceed, select the location and your virtual device. Lastly, check to make sure you have selected the correct destination location. On the following screen, enter a virtual connection name, your Google pairing key, and interface selection option, as well as the desired speed for your connection. Finally, review your order details and download an optional design summary before submitting the order. After submitting an order, you'll receive an email with the order details, as well as another email once the connection is provisioned. If you'd like to view, edit, or interact with your Network Edge assets, you can easily do so by navigating to the Connections Network Edge or Inventory tab, and by selecting Virtual Devices, Connections, or any other options from the dropdown. This concludes the overview of Network Edge. For additional resources and information, visit the Network Edge product documentation site, which can be found at docs.equinix.com.